Everyone have their own priorities, their own rights. But in India, it is totally opposite. Many face problems expressing their feelings in society. I am one of them. I am a homosexual. A homosexual in the largest democracy in the world. Things should be easier for me with superlatives like that. But they aren't. In fact, they have been difficult. It took me many years to gain the courage to look into the mirror and tell myself that the person I see is gay. Faced homophobia at a time that I wasn't even sure of my sexuality. I am a survivor of child sexual abuse. I was raped by a male relative for 11 long years, from the age of 7 to 18. I had confided in a friend, and that friend thought it was newsy enough to share with everybody in college. When people heard that I was a man who was raped by a man when I was a young lad, they assumed that I must be gay. They presumed my sexuality at a time when I was grappling with words and definitions. More than a decade of abuse had left me maimed in terms of sexual responses. I took longer to understand what my sexuality was. But at that time, I knew one thing for sure. Being gay would mean being subjected to ridicule. Even the British leftist Section 377, a law that punished anyone who had carnal intercourse against the order of nature. What's order of nature? Love for me is order of nature, and I am a man who loves men. What if between Tarzan and Jane, Tarzan's thigh attracts me more than Jane's breasts? But this cruel world does not care about others' feelings. Children get bullied for their sexuality in India and in the rest of the world. The pages of history have turned, but the story has remained the same. We are growing into being a world that judges more, loves less.
Depressed, dejected, harsh reality, and at the end, it's all empty inside.